Probably wondering why I called. It's about the favor you owe me.
Consider me at your service.
Okay. Remember that time I pulled you out of the water?
I may be old, but I'm not out to lunch. Of course I remember. And I always repay my debts. All you have to do is tell me how.
Okay. Let's just say, for argument's sake, that there was this person. This evil, vile person that did something so horrible, and she made the lives of everyone around her very miserable.
So this person's of the female persuasion?
Female, male. It doesn't really matter. But let's just say that this person made people's lives so miserable that someone finally decided enough was enough.
I assume this someone did something to stop the vile woman?
If they did, they probably wouldn't want anybody to know about it. But they would also probably worry that maybe someone would eventually find out about it, which is why they would probably want to do something to make sure everything stayed quiet.
Are you asking me to cover up a murder?
I never said murder. I never even
implied it. But if that is what you wanted, you'd be in luck. Happens to be my specialty. So, this murder you want me to cover up?
Please don't call it a murder.
Well, what would you prefer?
Whatever word describes an incident that takes the life of an evil person and makes the world a better place.
I'd call that fortunate. The cops might not.
Okay, the cops can't know about this, obviously.
Easy, Cookie. You're starting to sound a little guilty.
Why would you bring up the police?
Well, your father's the police commissioner, isn't he? You might want to back off the morning Joe before Daddy starts wondering why you're so jittery.
Okay, can we just back up to the favor that you owe me?
Of course. But before I agree to anything, there are a few matters we need to clarify.
Like?
For starters, a job like this requires a lot of finesse, especially since Dr. Niles being offed.
Who said anything about Lisa Niles?
I might not have a fancy degree like your doctor boyfriend, but I can still connect the dots. A lot of people had a bone to pick with Lisa Niles, including you and me.
You? Wait, that night that I picked you up out of the water, you said you had an altercation with a beautiful woman. That was Lisa?
Girl had impeccable timing, I'll hand her that. One minute we're having a civilized conversation, the next, wham! I'm treading water in the harbor and bleeding from my gut.
That must have made you really angry.
Well, after I got over the initial shock, I was pretty ticked. Mostly that she caught me off guard. I wonder if Lisa saw it coming when she got hit.
You tell me.
How would I know?
Well, you just admitted that you were angry after Lisa attacked you, which gives you a motive for murder. I'm starting to think that that favor that I asked you isn't much of a favor at all, since it stands to benefit you just as much, if not more, to have the whole incident with Lisa covered up.
That's what you think.
Well, you said it yourself. You were angry and Lisa attacked you. It doesn't really make you look innocent because she died that same night. So, if you want me to keep quiet, you're gonna have to help me.
Let me get this straight. You're blackmailing me to do a favor I already copped to owing you in the first place?
Well, it seems like you want this investigation to go away just as much as I do.
There's a lot of people in this town who wanted Lisa to disappear for good and are sleeping better now that she has. And a lot of them are in your immediate family.
Yeah, but none of us have a history of violence. So if the police find out that you had a little run-in with Lisa that same night?
I would be moved to the top of the suspect list and all your problems would be solved.
So if you want me to keep quiet, I'm going to need some assurance that I'll be protected.
There's all kinds of ways to keep you quiet, Cookie.
I wasn't trying to insult you.
No one likes being backed into a corner, Cookie, especially not me.
No, of course you don't. They are cramped and uncomfortable.
Whenever someone tries, I tend to react badly.
But I wasn't trying, I swear.
Now, it's lucky for you I have my orchids now. They've taught me patience, something I was sorely lacking in the past. Well, it's not surprising. I'm Italian. The smallest thing could set me off.
Well, that was then. This is now.
I mean, everyone has their limits. And there's always a chance the kinder, gentler Anthony I'm trying to become could have a relapse.
We definitely don't want that, do we? You know, I think Kate has some orchids in her office.
Stay right where you are.
I was afraid that you would say that.
Listen to me. I like you. And because you haven't said anything about pulling me out of the harbor...
And I won't. I mean, if anybody can keep her mouth shut, it is me, Maxie Jones.
Okay, then. Let's get this straight.
Okay.
I want to know who I'd be covering for.
Is that detail really necessary?
For instance, should I make it look like your doctor boyfriend offed Lisa to save you, or like you did it to save him?
I was actually thinking that we could make it somebody completely unrelated, because then we're both off the hook. And hey, so are you, so added bonus.
I like the way you think, Cookie.
So you're gonna do it? Just so we're clear, I don't want to know any details.
Deniability has its advantages.
Yeah, especially when it comes to my dad. I mean, I want to be able to plead ignorance if he starts getting suspicious and asks a bunch of questions.
Well, you ask plenty yourself, Cookie.
I only asked if you were gonna do it.
Wouldn't me saying yes be one of those details you're trying to avoid?
Does that mean you're gonna do it?
I'll consider it.
What does that mean?
That means that I'll keep your offer in mind and we'll see what comes of it. It's interesting to know what you're capable of. You got guts, Cookie. Makes me want to keep this as clean and clear as possible.